Hello all, we have already seen that how these microorganisms play a major role in our lives. Now let us see, based on their behavior, these microbes are classified into two types. One is friendly microorganisms and the other harmful microorganisms. The microorganisms which are useful for us are called friendly microorganisms. And the microorganisms which causes harm to plants, animals and human beings are called harmful microorganisms. Here are some areas where these microorganisms are useful to us. So the first one is preparation of curd, bread, cake, etc. Production of alcohol. Second, increasing the soil fertility. Third, cleansing the environment. Fourth, medicinal use. So all these we have already discussed. Now we will learn about harmful microorganisms. As I already told you that these harmful microorganisms causes diseases in humans, animals and plants. These disease causing microorganisms are called pathogens. So how this entry of pathogens takes place into our body? So there are different ways how these pathogens are entering our body. So what first one is through food, water or air, through cuts in the skin or direct skin contact, and carriers such as mosquitoes, flies, etc. Different disease causing microorganisms, pathogens causes different diseases. So the microorganisms which causes a particular disease, we call them as causative organisms. Okay, so for example, malaria is caused by a protozoan called Plasmodium. So another example, typhoid is caused by Salmonella typhi. The knowledge about the causative organism, their life cycles and different modes of the transmission of the disease is very helpful in effective prevention of that particular disease. Now we will see what are the different types of diseases. So here are two different types of diseases. The first one is non-communicable diseases and the second is communicable diseases. Now if you see the non-communicable diseases, mostly malnutrition diseases comes under this category. As the name itself says that these diseases cannot be spread from one person to another person. For example, night blindness. So this disease is mainly caused due to deficiency of vitamin A. So it is a malnutrition disease. So it cannot spread from one person to another person. Now if you see communicable diseases, now these diseases are generally caused by pathogens and they can spread from one person to another person. For example, the present situation which we are facing is COVID-19 viral infection, which can spread through droplets that is present in the air, which is the main reason, and it also spreads through other means as well. Now let us see different modes of transmission of diseases. Now these pathogens can be transmitted from the source of infection either directly or indirectly. If it is a direct transmission, it can be spread through direct contact, droplet infection, or through infected needle or syringe. If it is an indirect mode of transmission, the organism can spread through food, water, carriers, or the patient's clothes, towels, or personal utensils. Under direct transmission of diseases, the first one is direct contact. Here, the disease spreads from direct skin-to-skin contact or mucosa-to-mucosa contact or from mucosa-to-skin contact. For example, leprosy and conjunctivitis, which is an eye infection, spreads through direct contact from one person to another person. The second one is droplet infection. When an infected person, when he is talking or when he is spitting, sneezing or coughing, he releases droplets of moisture from his mouth. So at that time, these droplets may enter into a healthy person and he may become sick. For example, tuberculosis or COVID-19, etc. The third one is through infected needle or syringe. Now, the infection can also be transmitted directly by blood transfusion. For example, AIDS virus can be entered into a healthy person through blood transfusion if the blood donor is an infected person. So, under indirect mode of transmission of diseases, I already told you how these diseases can spread through food, water, carriers, clothes, towels, and personal utensils of the patient. And in most of the cases, these diseases can be spread through carriers, for example, houseflies, mosquitoes, and cockroaches, insects, etc. Now, for example, if you take this houseflies, generally they feed and multiply in the garbage or on human excreta or animal excreta. Now, these are the favorable places for the disease-causing microorganisms to grow. Now, when these houseflies sit on that garbage for feeding, these disease-causing microbes will stick to the feet or hair of these houseflies, and when these houseflies move from one place to another place, such as food, water, they get contaminated. When this contaminated food and water are consumed by a healthy person, generally they become sick and they cause diseases. Now coming to prevention of diseases caused by microorganisms. So here, since we know there are different modes of transmission of diseases, we can avoid such diseases through following methods. So the first one is maintaining personal hygiene by taking bath daily, wearing clean clothes, etc., and keeping your house and surrounding areas clean, and do not let the garbage, kitchen waste stagnate at any place. Keep your house surroundings sprayed with proper insecticide at regular intervals. Clip your nails regularly. Always use clean water. Foods and other eatables should be properly stored and kept covered. Wash all the utensils and your hands thoroughly before taking your meals. Vegetables and fruits should be properly washed before eating. Drink boiled or purified water, particularly during rainy season. People suffering from infectious diseases should be isolated and their discharges should be disposed of properly. Children should be immunized against all the children diseases at proper time. Do not defecate and do not let others to defecate in the open places. Take balanced diet and do exercise regularly. A healthy body can resist diseases more effectively. In the next session, we will be discussing about the disease-causing microorganisms in animals and plants.